What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to G Myers World, and it's very important that you guys check this video out immediately, bro. Like I said, this right here is going to be kind of crazy because some of you guys that watch the the Madden daily videos that they put out, some of you guys can catch it, some of you guys can't, some of you guys prefer to watch me. That's always appreciative. Thank you so much for, you know, using my channel as a resource to make sure that you up to date with all the Madden news. I definitely appreciate it. So this is what's going on, right? If you guys have been watching my video since the most feared started, you would remember I had like 150,000 bats, and then I went crazy, and then I just went into the store and I started using that currency in the store to get players. The reasoning behind that is it's several things, right? Number one, you have to know what you're doing. It's something that you have to understand when it comes to the way the currency is used. You have to use it when the actual promo is going on. All right, what does that mean? If we just leave the bats the way they are, you're gonna get 25% of it. So it's like, you know, what is it? 1 to 4 to 1 or something like that. For every 4 bats, you get one training point. So it's 25%. EA is taking 25% of all the bats that you accumulated. So if you went bat crazy, guess what, bro? You're about to lose 75%, and it's pretty much it. But in my case, I can get some wins out of it, do different things with the players, and try to utilize whatever else I have going on with the players that I currently have. Okay, so I still have 10,125 bats, whatever. So that would mean I would get 2,500 if you just round it off to the 10,000, because it's a quarter of it. All right, with all these players, right? The way that it is, it's like 40 something. So you're gonna get around like 10,000 and change per the highest overall, 92 overalls or whatever like that, which will amount to a decent amount of training. Now, the reason that I need you guys to understand, if you did utilize your bats for these players, you're in good shape. Because even though they're taking that much from you, for me, I got like 3 players out of the 92 overall, that's like 45K. So it's gonna convert, like I said, a quarter of it is like, you know, 10-5, something like that. Like, bruh, it's math. You guys know where you're at with it. So 3 of them is gonna be about 30,000 plus in training, right? So from that training, what you're gonna do, now listen, you guys should have been playing during this time with these cards that are souped up, getting your wins up like I'm doing. I've been giving you guys the gameplay that you asked for and been, you know, trying to grind it out as much as possible so that you guys see that I was actually playing with the most feared and trying to get as much. Because, like, a lot of people, once you do something weird, they'll just quit because they're like, oh, they come out here like, oh, why is this guy 19 feet tall? All right, I'm out of here. Those guys will do that. So you'll be able to rack up a decent amount of wins during this time period, okay? Now, when it's all over, remember, the training currency is going to be something that you can utilize in different ways. So look, if we get 30,000, these 90 to 91 overall players, they're gonna still have value, all right? So you're gonna be able to make up some of the stuff that EA took from you, like indirectly. You see what I'm saying? Because every promo with this alternate currency, you're more than likely gonna lose. In certain cases, you might get lucky and they'll do like a couple mishaps, like with the snow. I don't know if you guys remember what happened with the snow last year, but many of us was able to get some cards with high overall values due to some things that happened with technical difficulties. But these are about to expire, right? You can see it. It's going to expire when when the new series drop, with Series 3 come November 1st. So Football Outsiders, the heavyweight players, it's different ways you can utilize the training. I'm pretty sure they're going to add something else to take over the Mutt Hero situation. Right now, obviously, you can't do anything because you have to wait for it to convert before you can actually use it. But the reason that I wanted you guys to understand that it doesn't make sense for you to just keep your bats the way they are and just take the 25%, I would say to utilize it inside the store. Go into games, beat people's brains in with the players. Because look, I pulled 3 of these. I got Earl Thomas, I got Cam Newton, and I got the center. Those players are going to help me win games during this period. As soon as it's over, they're getting raid sold effective immediately. Bro, effective immediately. These dudes are gone before they even got to the locker room. Technically, they were in the locker room because I was using them for the gameplay, but they're going to be fired immediately. Okay, so with that being said, it's very, very important that you use whatever you have. Like for right now, what do I have, 10,000 bats? All right, so look, it's an 85 to 88 overall random player, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and use this right here. Why am I using this on that and not trying to build a player? It's simple because I told you guys before, with the way that everything is going, oh, whoa, 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 a 90? It says 85 to 88. Oh, because he's enraged now. Okay, I'm about to say, like, what's going on here? All right, so what is this guy? 89 speed? Really? He's enraged with that? Okay, man. This guy sucks. Like, it's not even a joke about it. That guy sucks right there. Like, I'm not even going to set trip. That dude's garbage. But that's not what this is about. What this is about is you have to make sure that you just use the backs up. So that way, you know what I'm saying, it doesn't really matter when it comes down to it. You'll just have the player that you could probably put into your lineup right now. And then doing that, you go into a game and just manhandle somebody. All right, now, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to kind of give you guys an example of what happens, right? Because the house rules, I believe it's still active, right? Yeah, it's still going on. So what I'm going to do is we're going to hop into a game, and then you're going to see what I'm talking about. It's very, very wild because, you know, the tug of war, whatever. This is the situation, right? When you come out, like, if you want to do the quick games, you do the quick games. For me, I'm playing a lot of head-to-head because you get so much more from doing the head-to-head. So it makes sense to do that. Let me go ahead and make sure that everything is set with my settings over here, so that way I don't really have to worry about having to talk to people on the mic and all that kind of weird stuff, because dudes are weirdos, just be doing whatever they want. So look, now that that's done, right, you go into the game. If you wanted to do house rules, there is no way possible that I'm going to sit here and spend my days playing 100 of these games. But many of you guys have done the house rules. You've played the tug of war. You've got the 100 wins. Congratulations to you guys. I don't have it in me. After the 75, I vowed that I wouldn't do it. It's too long and it's excessive. It's just too much. So I don't feel comfortable doing it. If you guys have the time to do it, feel free to do it. But this is the time to utilize what you get right now for value. Okay, so you come out with this right here. You know what makes this unique? They can't really see your team. So when you come out, if your players are erased, say you got like a Lockett who burns everybody because he's so big and stupid, like that dude just runs around like a complete idiot, it'll definitely benefit you a lot. So for me, what I do is I just come out with Cam on offense and I just try to, you know, throw the ball to Randy Moss. I really, really tried to pull Lockett and I was unsuccessful doing so. So it is what it is right now. He got a, who was that, Ray Lewis in the middle right there? Like who is that? Why is that dude just looking that? Oh, he got a guy on the other side too looking that big. And they're just all floating back though. So I'm gonna go that way, over here to this side, and just see what we could do with that. Okay, so obviously, with the way that the game is designed, that animation is gonna happen anyway. That dude's gonna jump up in the air like an idiot. And that's it, that's pretty much it. So now defensively, we have Ray Lewis, we have Denzel Ward, we have so many, okay, he's coming out doing that. All right, we're gonna have to be careful, because I didn't even get to set up my D. All right, let me just see right here real quick. All right, we try to do this. All right, he's running the ball. All right, everybody check, okay. Okay, yeah, it don't matter how... Who is that? Oh, that's Coleman. He got Tevin Coleman? Oh, so he wants to run the ball on me. All right, I wanted to try to air it out, but he wants to run the ball. Should we run the ball back on him? Like, because we got... We got some grizzly dudes out there. Hold on. Because we got our center. You see how big Frederick looks? You can't really see him because the way that Cam Newton just goes and hovers over him. But he's kind of... Bro, he's kind of brolic, bro. Like, all right, yeah, we out. Bro, come. Who is that? That's Tillman? See, this is what makes it crazy. And this is what makes it time consuming. If you get a guy like this that's ready to just come out and just be a complete, yo, where's Lawrence Taylor? Let me set this up real quick. Von Miller over there. Okay, this guy stays there. Okay, so who was I putting here? I gotta put somebody, okay, hold on. Let me go back to what I was doing here real quick. Cause like, I didn't see what he was doing, but it doesn't matter. All right, so how many people does he have back there? How many people, what is he? Okay. Bruh, Tim is still late. Oh, Tariq Cohen, that dude's garbage. I've been got rid of. Okay, so what are we? What did it say we're gonna do? Okay, so he wants to run the ball and be an idiot. So we can't even. We don't have a big receiver. And Cam Newton, the defense that he's playing, I'll be setting myself up to throw interceptions. So pretty much, you have to just do what you have to do. And like I said, I didn't like the way Tariq Cohen was as an enraged player. So I immediately downgraded him back and took his stuff back. All right, hold those. Okay, we up. Oh, they made him tackle me. Usually when. They dove like that, they didn't usually give up the tackle because it was like a glitch. Like, you could just dive and be an idiot and it didn't work. All right, Savage is big too, right? So we can put this guy, Tillman here. Palomalu, Earl Thomas. Okay, who is anybody else big? Lattimore. Okay. All right, hold up. Let me do this real quick. All right, hold up. Let's see what he's doing. Let's see. Why? Yo, bro, these players are so much bigger than Vic, though. Who is that? Who just tackled him? Earl Thomas? Earl Thomas is looking like a complete idiot, bro. And like I said, this is why I have an issue with it. Because this guy is trying to, you know, you see the coverage that he's playing? He's just trying not to give up the big play, and I don't have a player that can run by him. So I just have to, you don't say, I got to try to run the ball, and then it becomes a little bit more ridiculous. Actually, I could have just flipped that, but the way that it is with this one, all right, run it up. Oh my God! Who made that? Oh, that's Polamalu. All right, about to say, who made that tackle, man? That's just outrageous that this, all right, he's still running pistol. Yeah, this guy, bro, I'm starting to like this guy. Like, what the? Hold on, let me see what he's doing. Let me see what this guy's doing, man. Like, bro, I'm starting to like this man. Like, all right, where you going with that? Where you going? Oh, bruh! Okay, you know what? You know what we're gonna do right now? Cause he just really aggravated me. We about to run on aggressive. We about to run, cause like that juke, that it just made my butt cheeks perk up. Like, you want to really come out here and juke me like that in front of my viewers? Like, bro, right in front of my viewers though? Okay, bro, no. Like, all right, let me see what we doing. We just go. I pop out at your party. Like, listen, man. Let's. Oh yeah, I'm about to say. I know you in zone. How's that guy moving like that? No, man, you idiot! Why did you spin like that so wide, bro? He just spun, bro, that was gonna go for six, too. Come on, man. Bro, that was legitimately about to go for six. What is he doing now? Come here, bro, I pop up at your party. Like, bro, what are you doing, man? And it's gonna be your rob, like, what is this dude doing? Why did he just do that, right? You know what I should, yo, honestly? Like, real talk, no, I could probably eat him up with this, bro. I'm gonna have to stay in this, man, because the D he's playing right now is just aggravating me. Like, he's playing that D where you just want to go and just, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what is this guy doing, man? Why is he playing D like this? This dude's defense is mad stupid, bro. Bro, just hold that, hold your blocks. There we go. Okay, spit. No! Earl Thomas with the clutch hit stick, though? Bro, Earl Thomas, okay, he's coming out a bunch. All right, that's what we wanted. That's what we were waiting for him to do. Now we're about to send A-gap pressure. We should be good. Everybody's ready for this. Let's go. You see how many big dudes we got out there? Go ahead. Yeah, there you go. Pop out at your pop. Oh. How does he not fumble that? Yo, this game right. Okay. Yes, sir. Bro, EA, you got it, man. You got it. Like, whatever you want. Whatever you want, EA, you got it. Like, Michael Vick is not enraged. Why did he not fumble? Why did Michael Vick just not fumble that ball, bro? That just aggravated the hell out. Hold the blocks! You fat idiot! Travis Frederick, man! Why would you let him tackle me and you see me trying to go for sacks? Like, all right, this guy wants to run. Okay, hold on. Okay, we're gonna have to fix this. Earl Thomas, you ready? Everybody's mad big back there. All right, he's gonna just run this for six and just get it over with. Just run it for six and get it over with, bro. Okay, all right, man. All right, that was a lot of yards. We just gave up a whole lot of yards right there, so unless we get something big right here, we're pretty much, you know what I'm saying? We're pretty much just screwed. We got to get a huge run right here, because that was just wild that nobody wanted to make a tackle. That whole situation was crazy. Why did he back everybody off like that? That was stupid. Now we're about to run this for six, though. How did Tillman just hide behind the other guy like that? Tillman just hid when I spin moved the other guy and was not affected at all by what just happened, and I got hit-sticked instantly. All right, so we gotta just get over here. All right, come on. Get this guy. Get him. Yeah, Tillman just be hiding out, bro. Tillman just be hiding behind everybody and just be waiting to hit stick somebody, bro. He just backed everybody. I think he's scared. He kind of figures that he can't really give up any big play, but he just has his coverage is just so stupid. Let me see. What can we do here, bro? Because the other side, I think, yeah, we're going to have to just try it again. The left side has been weak. Travis Frederick really, he really hurt us on that. Because we had a very, very good opportunity to go for six, bro. What are you doing? What the heck? Yo, why did they add that stupid thing back into the game with the stumble? Bro, I was going for six. Like, bro, six. Like, what the? And put it like this, EA wanted you to play 100 games like this. Just think about that. Like, it's supposed to be quick games. EA wanted you to play 100, though. Like, yeah, it doesn't matter. Yeah, it looks like, unless we throw a dot that's just so hot right here. Unless we throw a dot that's so hot, like, it doesn't matter. This one's over. Bro, why am I in that formation? I picked the wrong play. Unless we throw a dot that's so hot, like, this is just craziness, man. This is really craziness. Imagine, okay, hold up. What did we... see what Cam. Let me see what Cam Newton tried to do. Are you trying to back people off? Yeah, he just doesn't want to give up the big play. We're gonna see what Randy Moss got in him. Okay, they gave him a one-handed pick. Sounds good to me. Bro, sounds good to me, man. That's what these guys do. They know with the house rules, if you don't got a player that's like, you know, explosively like large, bro, like they just come out and just play coverage like that, there's nothing you can really do about it. You gotta just sit there and be an idiot with EA and just be like, yo, what's good? This guy just stays in coverage the entire game and okay, hit stick him. Alright, goals updated? Alright, he got it? Yeah, he got the win. He got the win. But you guys can see what's going on with it. Yeah, obviously we did lose. Like, bro, it is what it is. But again, that's why I wanted Lockett. Because Lockett, I played against him, and he will literally run past that backed up coverage or whatever. But it's very, very hard to try to pull it, and you can't buy it from the store while they're enraged. So, you know, that's what I would urge you guys to do. Take advantage of the bats, use them in the game, try to get as many as you can, and then when it converts, you still get the same conversion as if you never used it, but at least you could get benefit from it and play some games and possibly get some wins, all right? If you have any other questions about it, please feel free to contact, you know me on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Twitch. Community is very, very strong. They'll see the comments. You know, some cases I get back to you, but somebody will definitely be there to help you out with any problems you have regarding your ultimate team. I'm going to see you guys and girls next time. You have a good one. One love, y'all.